everyone, today I'm going to be telling you about working in a casino. In my life I've had many different jobs and I thought that I would start this mini series telling you what it's like to work in these jobs, just in case you're thinking about applying or just in case you're wondering what it's like to work in these industries. Working in the casino had been my dream job for years, and even though I didn't really mind working in the betting shop, I decided to leave to pursue this dream and it wasn't all it was cracked up to be. I was invited to attend an interview in the casino in Glasgow Street in Glasgow, and you have to complete a maths test and then do a one-to-one interview. During this interview, she tells you that you're basically not going to have a life and you're not going to have time to see your friends because of the shifts that you're given. You're given really long shifts and sometimes at night. And at the time, I was happy to do this because my best friend already worked there and I was single at the time. Training was a few weeks long and it was group training. You had to learn all your times tables up to 50 and you sat a maths test every single day. The first games that you were taught how to deal were roulette, 3-card brag and 5-card poker. Brag and 5-card poker were pretty basic and therefore they were my favourite games to deal. Roulette was a bit more challenging. You had to learn different pattern bets so that if somebody put chips down in a certain pattern, you didn't really have to add it up, you just knew how much to give them. You also had to learn how to form the chips into different shapes, so that if you were pushing out a stack of chips, you would put your fingers into a certain position to push them out so that the stack didn't fall over. Luckily, I already knew how to play roulette. Some people think you just put chips on individual numbers, but there's so many different bets, such as neighbour bets and racetrack bets, as well as many others. Once training was almost over, you had to sit an exam to get a gambling licence, as you're not allowed to deal any games without one. After that, you were allocated to the casino that you would be working in, and thankfully I was kept in the casino in Glasgow Street because it would have been a bit more difficult for me to travel to any other casino in Glasgow. The first few shifts that I was given were day shift, and that's because it's a bit quieter during the day. The problem that I had with this is that the roulette tables are normally 50 pence bets, and I found them a bit harder to calculate. In the casino that I worked in, there was 4 separate tables, 2 roulette tables and 2 card tables, and 1 pit boss in the middle. And any time you paid out a bet, you would call out what you were paying, and the pit boss would turn round to quickly look and make sure you were giving out the right amount. Some of the more stressful things when you start off isn't really calculating the winnings. You have so many other things to remember. For example, when you're dealing roulette, you have to remember to spin the wheel a different way each time. When you're paying out or when you're going to touch money or take any bets, you have to clear your hands, and that's to make sure that you don't have anything in your hands before you pass anything out, basically to make sure that you're not stealing any money. When you're dealing cards, you have to remember to put your hand across the table to show that you're getting ready to deal. And when you're dealing roulette, you have to clear all the chips away in a specific way so that the camera can see everything clearly. Every single thing that you do in the casino is recorded on camera and on the mic as well. Every few weeks your work is assessed and they decide if you're ready to move up a tier. For every few tiers you move up, you're paid a little bit more and you're taught to deal different games. As I said before, 3-card brag and 5-card poker were my favourite games to deal. Not only because they were the easiest ones, but because you also get a chance to talk to the customers a little bit as well. Just because these games were easy to deal didn't mean they were problem free. In the casino that I worked in, we had quite a lot of Chinese guests, and apparently the number 4 is really unlucky in China. When you're playing 3-card brag, the dealer gets 3 cards and the customers get 3 cards. They're allowed to check their cards and decide if they're going to play them, and once they've decided, they're not allowed to touch their cards again. So if I was ever playing and I would turn my cards over and I had 3 fours, there was these 3 women in particular who used to come in, and they would go absolutely insane if you had 3 fours. Like, they would start screaming at you and throwing things at you. And sometimes they would pick up their cards and throw them at you. And like I said, the customer isn't allowed to pick their cards back up once they've decided if they're betting or not. And oh my God, I had people take things out of their handbags and throw them at me and scream at me and call me an evil witch and everything. No matter what game you're dealing, it's obvious that people don't like to lose money. And particularly at night when people have been drinking and they're quite drunk, they're going to accuse you of being a cheater, they're going to throw things at you and call you names. Sometimes they even threaten your life. I mean, there were so many times that people would tell me that they were going to wait outside and kill me after work.
I just wanted to add in here that if you work in a casino and you drive, your job can be classed as high risk. If you're applying for car insurance and you tell them that you work in a casino and that you plan to take your car to work, your car insurance is likely to be a lot higher. Also, the casino that I worked in had a car park attached, and you could reclaim your parking money at the end of your shift.
Although I didn't mind dealing roulette, I wasn't allowed to deal to high rollers because they've got a higher maximum bet and they like to have a more experienced dealer or a pit boss because of the amount of money that they might be paying out. But every now and then the high rollers would come in and we didn't have anybody else to take over, so I would have to deal to them and then the pit boss would have to stand right next to me to make sure that I was paying out the right amount. And it was quite nerve-wracking because high rollers will sometimes just take out stacks of £100 notes and just throw them onto a number. And at night the casino can be really busy, so you're trying to take in all these chips and you're trying to count all this money and you need to make sure that you've put it onto the right number and that you're paying out the right amount, and it can be quite stressful. As I mentioned, you're likely to be called a cheater at least once a day, and it didn't help the day that I spun the same number 15 times in a row on roulette. The first four times, a few customers had noticed and they came over and they were like, oh, that's a bit weird, the same numbers came out. So they started all putting their chips on that number, but then the crowd started getting bigger and everybody started noticing that I kept spinning this number. So the pit boss came over and he was spinning my wheel for me. He was telling me to spin the ball faster, spin it in a different direction, and no matter what I'd done, this same number kept coming out. As the crowd started to gather around the table, everybody was packing their chips onto this number, and it got to the point where there was no more space left on the number and I had to take all the bets individually. The managers were over in the corner watching it on the camera, and at this point everybody was on their lunch and there was nobody else to take me off the table. And everybody was just looking at me, everybody was just thinking that I was cheating, that I could do this deliberately and I couldn't. And I just kept spinning and spinning, and by the time it got to the 10th time, one of the managers came over and he basically said, look, you can't spin this number again or you'll get in trouble. So at this point I was panicking. I thought, I'm going to get sacked because this keeps happening. And I genuinely couldn't control what number this was landing on, and it just kept happening. So then it happened the 15th time in a row, and they got somebody to come over to the table. They got somebody to come off their lunch early to take over, and the manager took me over to the corner. And I really got in trouble for this, and I was like, I can't spin a number. I can't do it deliberately. It just happened by chance, and I don't think it was very fair that I got shouted at for something that wasn't even my fault. To be honest, in the time that I worked there, I had got pretty good at spinning the ball into a neighbour's bet, which is one number and the two numbers at each end. Now, I couldn't spin an exact number, although I did try. There was a few dealers in there who could do it. I seen them saying what numbers they were going to spin and then do it like six times in a row, and that's probably one of the reasons why you're not allowed to deal with friends and family. The casino has really strict rules about dating colleagues and customers, and you're not even allowed to deal any games to your friends, although everybody in there appeared to be sleeping with everybody else, so it didn't really make a difference. Once you work there for a while, you're trained in the cash office, and there's about five or six people in there at a time. And as I said, every single thing's recorded. Everything's recorded on camera, on mic. There's somebody standing writing everything down. Somebody counts the money. Somebody writes down how much is there. And it's really particular. And this is obviously to make sure that nobody's stealing anything. The highest prize that I dealt was on five-card stud poker. And it was an accumulative jackpot. And the person won £250,000. The sad thing is that we weren't allowed to take any tips at the time. Just a few months after I left, they changed that, so I could have lost out on quite a good tip. The person who won the £250,000 was on his graduation night out, and he was playing the bonus bet, and all his friends at the table were saying, oh, that's a waste of money, that's a pound to go, you're just wasting your money. And I says, well, it's not a waste of money if you get a royal flush and you win the jackpot. And then he ended up winning it. And he was trying to take pictures of his cards once he won, but you're not actually allowed to take pictures in the casinos in Glasgow, which is a bit strange because when you're in Vegas, they just let you take pictures and video everything. When the guy won the money, I was going round the table and paying everybody out, and he was the last one in the row, and he was absolutely freaking out, and he was like, oh my God, hurry up, because I think he just couldn't believe it. and all his friends at the table and everybody that was out with him were absolutely raging. You should have seen their faces. It was like they were just so miserable about it. At this point, you're probably thinking, that job doesn't sound that bad. Everybody who works for the public has to put up with some level of cheek. But the problem with the casino wasn't really the job, it was the staff. As I mentioned, relationships between staff were banned, but that didn't stop everybody from sleeping with each other, apart from me because I was heartbroken at the time. And there was so much drama and people were always fighting and bitching about each other behind each other's backs. There was a Polish guy who worked there who was really nice, and he worked almost every day of the week. And sometimes the casino bosses would ask him to do a late shift on an early shift. And because he stayed quite far away, he used to have to stay in the casino overnight and sleep on the pool table. Everybody knew that this was illegal, but the poor guy done it anyway just so that he could get a day off to spend it with his son. The entire time I worked there, there was one particular pit boss who was a complete cunt, and he just used to be cheeky and shout at everybody. And one day I was dealing roulette, and when I was pushing out the winnings, he turned round and says to me, "Oh my God, are you a fucking idiot?" And I turned round and I was just like, "What are you talking about?" And I hadn't even made a mistake. He was just saying that to try and make me look stupid in front of the customers. And I went absolutely insane. I started screaming at him. And you're not supposed to walk away from the table and leave your float open. But I just left it. I just walked away and I was like, "Don't ever speak to me like that again." He just used to call you stupid all the time. And even in the staff room, he just used to speak to you like total crap. So after I went crazy at him and started shouting at him and walked off the table, he started to get even worse with me. And he started calling me names and calling me stupid and saying to me, "Oh, you'll need to find a new job in reception," and just trying to make me feel bad about myself. But luckily I had a lot of self-confidence, so I didn't really care what he thought. So I went to the management and reported him for bullying. And this was the head manager. I didn't even go to like another pit boss or a supervisor. I went straight to the manager and she sat and took all her wee notes and she was like, "Oh, that's just Billy. He just speaks to people like that." And I was like, "He's not going to speak to me like that." Like, I refused to come into my work and be called an idiot or for somebody to try and make me feel bad about myself. And I want something done. A few weeks went past and nothing was done about it. But the manager obviously spoke to Billy and he spoke to some of the other pit bosses. And one of the other pit bosses, who was so insignificant I can't even remember his name, started to be cheeky to me as well. And every time my table was busy, he would say, "Oh, you're stupid, or you're thick, you need to get a new job, you can't work here anymore." And just being nasty to me for no reason. So I went and reported him. And once I had reported him, I says there was another dealer on and he was laughing. But I wasn't reporting him for bullying me, I was just saying he was there. Like, ask him what he was saying to me. So then later on that day, the two of them came into the staff room and they were like, "Oh, somebody's reported the two of us for bullying." And that wasn't even what happened. I reported one of them for bullying and I says that the other one was there. So the manager was just a complete joke. Over time, I started to complain about it more. And other dealers were telling me that they spoke to them in the same way. And I says, "Well, you might be willing to stand and let somebody call you an idiot and make you feel bad, but that's not what they're going to do to me." So I ended up complaining to the manager above my manager, and honestly, it was just totally unprofessional. Eventually, I was dealing roulette again on a busy table, and Billy turned round and just called me some random nasty name, and even the customers were saying to him, "Why are you allowed to speak to her like that?" And I just freaked out. I started screaming at him, and I just, like, there was quite a lot of bets on the table, and I just went nuts, and I just went like that and, like, hit all the bets off the table. Now, I could have been sacked for that, but they actually sent me to anger management. They sent me to anger management even though I was being bullied and I had been getting bullied for months. It was absolutely ridiculous. And all the time that I worked there, I had went to some different casinos to fill in for people who were sick or for casinos who were having special events. And to be honest, every single one that I worked in, the staff were the same. They were all sleeping with each other. The management were sleeping with the staff, the management were sleeping with each other, and this was completely banned, but it was just causing a really bad atmosphere. Not to mention the fact that half the pit bosses were bullies, and the management just done absolutely nothing about it. Although working in the casino wasn't the worst job in the world, many of the staff and management were absolutely toxic. Never let anybody speak to you in a degrading way. Understand that we can all have our jokes and we can say things that we don't mean. But when somebody's turning round basically every single day and calling you an idiot and trying to make you feel bad, it's important that you report them. And I know that it can be scary sometimes, especially if you have to report your manager. But if you have to go over your manager's head and report them, then that's just what you have to do, because they're just going to keep treating people like that, and it's unacceptable. The fact that I reported these two people several times, and I was the one that got sent to anger management, was an absolute joke. Now, I admit that I'm not the calmest person in the world, and I do tend to go on rants and go off my head sometimes, but I'm not about to stand and let somebody talk to me like an idiot just because their job's above mine. When I was younger, I used to love going to the casino, but I had such a bad experience while working there that I hardly ever go now, and the only time I really go is when I'm in Vegas. The last time I went to that casino, the name had changed, but some of the staff were the same, and some of the pit bosses are managers now, and to be honest, I can't even look at them because they're just an absolute joke. They think that they're so important because they're a manager or a pit boss in a casino. It's sad. Anyway, with all that being said, I hope that this gives you some idea of what it's like to work in a casino, especially some of the casinos in Glasgow. Let me know in the comments section if this is anything like what you were expecting. Also, let me know if you've worked in a casino and if you've experienced anything like this before. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you're new here, consider subscribing. Thanks for watching. Bye!